As an architectural designer, I'm always searching for more efficient ways of doing work. At the firm I work at, one of the things we produce is renders. So in this video, I'll be reviewing NVIDIA's Omniverse Create, a program for 3D modeling and rendering. Like the NVIDIA Canvas video, this program requires a NVIDIA graphics card to use. The computer I'm using is custom built, and you can see the specs in the description of this video. The most relevant component is my 3080 GPU. This is where the bulk of the rendering compute happens. So, for those who are unfamiliar, I first want to describe Omniverse Create. It's an app within the Omniverse ecosystem. Omniverse was launched in October of 2021, and its technology originates from Pixar's Universal Scene subscription, which NVIDIA has expanded in an attempt to make a foundational layer to the metaverse. Omniverse is a suite of programs and assets. By making the suite public, NVIDIA hopes to accelerate the creation of simulation technologies. So, in this suite, there are programs for viewing models, building applications, and even augmented reality. These programs connect to third-party programs using software called connectors. Create, as its name implies, is for 3D scene creation. The closest comparison I can think of is Epic Games' Unreal Engine. When it comes to rendering, I have experience in Unreal, Lumion, and Rhino. All three of these programs are great in different ways. Unreal has the best assets and editability. Lumion is the best results for the least work, and Rhino is the best 3D modeler. In this video, I'll specifically be using Lumion to compare it to Create. To launch Create, we first launch Omniverse, click on Library, select the Create app, and launch. Now, you'll be presented with a GUI that's similar to many other 3D modeling programs. I'll be using a pool model for comparison. So let's import that. Create prefers you import through the connectors, so you download those to link to other programs. In this case, SketchUp. In importing, I actually had an issue with my layers, which is easily solved by better organizing them in SketchUp. However, I was frustrated that I could not find a way to correct the issue in the Create app. It doesn't seem to allow editing of the meshes of imported models. Another issue I had was with importing FBX files. If not specified in the file, the materials will be lost in Create. Apparently, Create attempts to replace original materials with its own. I solved this by relinking materials, but not all of my FBX files had accompanying materials. This problem also applied to SketchUp objects with non-default materials. The material system uses .mdl, which is a file type that I have zero experience with. This is fine, but I wish that Create would play better with other file types, especially considering that this is a feature that they advertise on. The program's library is pretty good, especially its integration into other libraries as a marketplace. My workplace gets very specific with plant models, so it's not comprehensive enough for our purpose, but for general scenes, I think it's fine. But now we get into my biggest gripe, the duplicate hotkey. I don't know if it's just that I didn't spend enough time on it or what, but I could not figure out what the hotkey for drag duplicating an object is. If there is none, that's bad. If there is, I couldn't easily find documentation for it, which is less bad. I hope it's the latter, because lacking a simple but highly used feature like that leads to a lot of time wasted. Getting into the rendering, I like the camera a lot more than many programs. The reason being is they went for a realistic camera, as opposed to an easy one. This is the type of camera that has a learning curve, but will translate to actual photography. The rendering engine is RTX Renderer, and I do like its quality. It's very accurate to real life. There is a downside though. The renderer works similarly to V-Ray in that it starts noisy and reduces that noise as it goes through cycles. This is not something that exists in a program like Lumion and can be pretty annoying, mostly because it is up to the user to decide when the noise is small enough and the time it takes to fully render is pretty high. While rendering, the viewport can also not be moved, let alone batch rendering multiple cameras. As for post-processing, there's a lot you can do with the settings. However, everything is very technical and it doesn't have filters or styles. These are the final renders and I'm going to link them in the video description. As you can see, the noise is prominent on the building. Had I waited longer to render, this could have been removed, but these already took, on average, 15 minutes while Lumion is much quicker. For some reason, at the same field of view, the cameras captured different ratios. While it looks nice, Omniverse Create's water was only able to be transparent in the program's max rendering settings, and its options tie transparency to reflectivity. Grass is another issue. There are no presets for 3D grass. This results in a much more unrealistic render. Now, you can place grass models, but there's also no paint placement feature. Some shots turned out nice. Like, this one benefits from the ray tracing with its shadows. Yet, there's also the ugly. This night scene just didn't look like night. There's definitely my ignorance at play, but look how much better the Lumion render turned out. I could not easily make the frame lights shine or turn the night sky dark. So with all that said, what's my verdict? Well, Create has great potential. It's not ready yet. However, NVIDIA's vision is the most ambitious and comprehensive of any company in the market. Being a new entrant, who knows if they will find their place and be a true competitor? But there is no other rendering engine company, to my knowledge, that is also making their own GPUs. This intimacy is one of the reasons I believe NVIDIA is a true dark horse in the space. Not to mention, their available resources and excellent track record. I'll definitely be keeping my eye on Omniverse's progress as time goes on.